Are you mesmerized by nature? Are you curious about the hidden spirits of the forest? Then this oracle deck might just be for you. What's up, everyone? It's your boy, Kyle Gray. Welcome back to my channel. My intention for life is to help as many people get spiritually connected as humanly possible. And I do that through a number of means, including writing books and creating oracle decks. In this channel, I like to share with you some of the coolest, most trendy, most unusual oracle decks that you can find in the world. And today's deck is something that's pretty cool. This is not something I would normally be drawn to, but for whatever reason, when I saw this sitting on the bookshelf, it jumped right out at me. Today, I'm speaking about the Forest Fae. And this is a pocket deck by Nadia Turner, and it has been published by Rockpool Publishing. It says, "Curious Messages of Enchantment. Enter the forest, seek wonder and enchantment, and hear the curious messages of the Forest Fae. This set of 40 magical cards invites you to delight in your imagination and spark joy and inspiration. Go beyond the boundary between this world and that, to escape your way into the forest and to magic." It's a beautiful little box. It's got this little being on the front, mushrooms growing, and you open up the box. It's magnetic, which I really love that, how it's put together. And it says, how to use the cards. Sit quietly and breathe deeply. Shuffle the deck while thinking of a question, or just ask the Fae for guidance. Choose a card at random and discover what messages the Forest Fae have for you. Perhaps the answers will be clear, or maybe they will ask more questions before the answer. Such is the way of the Fae. Now, you know, let's just talk about this before we jump into this oracle deck today. And it doesn't say it's an oracle deck, but I'm going to call it that just for speaking sake. You know, I've always been fascinated by fairy tales, and I've always been fascinated by the energy of the unseen, and I've spent my entire career investigating and experiencing the energy of angels, the magic, and the unseen. And it's not that I have disregarded the fae or disregarded the idea of fairies and these kind of unseen nature spirits. It's just, I've had a different name for them. And if you've saw some of my other work, such as the Angels and Ancestors Oracle, I actually have these beings in that deck called the Guardians. And they've been depicted as angels, but if you read the book, you'll see that I'm actually speaking about these kind of unseen elemental energies of the earth. So I genuinely believe that within nature, there are devas and spirits and guiding forces. And I'm not saying they look like what is in this deck, but for me, I think there's something really exciting about giving these beings, these unseen spiritual presences in nature, a face and an image so that we can approach it. And I believe that this intelligence is there for us to connect with. And I think that nature is such a powerful, amazing space that we probably should be giving more time and energy to. These spirits feel more approachable than ever because this earth is changing, and, you know, climate change is real, and, you know, everything's happening all around us on this earth. And I think the earth is trying to evolve and trying to heal herself. And I think if we can be more in connection of her guiding spirits, then maybe we'll learn what we can do in our own lives and our own worlds to contribute to greater change. And I think the way we do that is by developing a personal relationship with these unseen beings. And I think oracles such as the Forest Fae kind of gives us this magic at our fingertips to be able to consider that connection and to investigate for ourselves, is that actually real? So I was drawn to this. I thought it looked super duper cool. There's no information about the artist on the actual box, But I found her on social media, so you'll be able to find her if you really want to learn more about her. Just Google search Nadia Turner Artist, and it's the artist that's also done the words. So let's have a look at this little beautiful oracle. The first card is the Soothsayer. Travel the road seldom taken. To the greenwood, seek comfort and acceptance. Be kind to yourself. And you'll see some of these beings are pretty unusual looking. But I can't help but feel, even though I know she's in Australia, there's a real Celtic energy with these beings. You know, in Celtic spirituality, we acknowledge the different versions of the old gods. And Cernunnos, you know, this horned god of fertility and life and vibrancy, has these horns, which many kind of Christian belief systems have kind of made to be dark and negative, but really it's just because they didn't understand it. So when you see these beings, go beyond the limitations of the patriarchy, go beyond the limitations of Abrahamic religion, and realize that what the artist is creating here is something much more ancient than that. The old one, the ancestors call, seek their wisdom. The Green Maid. Okay, now we're turning into proper Celtic stuff. You know, if you have ever been to a church in Scotland, you'll probably see green men somewhere carved into the building and green people. The Green Maid, the Green Fae speak to you. Let them guide you to safety. The Mandragora Mother, find the secrets hidden in the brambles. I quite like this mystery because it's about, you know, looking deeper. So, you know, messages like that are inviting us to see beyond the surface. The wild god. Go to the woods, to moss, to mud, to magic. The forest walker. Keep courage, be gentle. This was my favorite card when I looked through this last night because it only arrived yesterday. The Silent One, watch the shifting shadows and be a caretaker of silence. The Green Man, embrace your wildness. Before we go any further, one of my first tattoos was a green man, because when I first got interested in spirituality, I was more drawn to the witchy side, and I was more drawn to like Wicca and Druidry and the Celtic traditions. And the Green Man was one of these figures that was able to survive the rise of, you know, Christianity and this kind of set religion. And he was originally this pagan guardian of the forest, which then was found in many of the kind of churches and temples all over the British Isles as this protector. So I love that he's in there. The witch hare. Cross the threshold, leap the hedge, go over the wall. So quite fairy tale-esque, and I think this could also be really healing for your inner child. The autumn fae. Go slowly and listen closely for the words of the tree spirits. The Troll Fae, follow the secret signs as treasures can be found where you least expect them. Hedge Guardians, walk Widdershins and seek the land under the hill. Now, if you don't know what Widdershins is, it's anti-clockwise. So it's about moving in a different direction from what you normally move. So when you're in a magical circle in kind of Wicca, Widdershins is moving backwards, moving anti-clockwise around the circle. Seed spells. Create your story. It is the most potent form of magic. Fringe dweller. See with eyes and heart wide open. I don't know if that means hidden behind your fringe, but I like what it's up to. The old paths, walk in unknown territory to see from a new perspective. Lady of the lost, give to others treasure life and its magic. spiny sister, take pride in yourself. And it's kind of like a porcupine being. The Griffin. Gryffindor! Yes, be brave and fly above the clouds. Away we fly. Take the cloud roads. Delight in your imagination. The Gatekeeper. Let go. All things are possible on the borderlands. She of the Mossy Brae. Oh, that's very Scottish. She of the Mossy Brae. Not all things are as they seem. Trust in your intuition. The Fairy Harper. Find the words to long-forgotten songs and dance to the music in your soul. The Spell Singer. Cast spells of wonder and delight. The Sentinel. New opportunities shall manifest in unexpected ways. The Mandrake Spirit. Gosh, this is so Harry Potter, like magical vibes. Like, let's just jump down Diagon Alley and pick up a copy of The Forest Fae. Keep yourself rooted in the earth. Spring is coming. Dream deep. The Numia. Seek inspiration in twilight wanderings. Shout out to all my night owls. The Gnome of Mushrooms and Buttons. Seek silliness and joy. They are wise teachers. The Thimble Witch. There is magic in beginnings, so start something new. The Spirit Familiar. Seek loving connections and cherish friendships. Keep going. Trust in yourself. You have all you need. The Woodwife. Trust your inner wisdom. The Honey Mother. Sometimes the greatest magic lies in the smallest of forms. The Northwood Fae. Take time for hibernation and healing. Strange Journeys. Look at this card. It's so cool. Take control of your quest. Choose your companions wisely. Forest Sister. The moon shines brightest after the storm. The Storyteller. Stories are medicine, strengthening and renewing. Walker of the Wind. You can see there's a little fae person on the raven. The raven shows the way. Be courageous. Change and chance can bring exciting wonders. Owl Song. Whisper secrets to the moonlight. Find strength in stillness. The Green Witch. Connect to the spirits and energy of your local landscape. Seek enchantment. So this is a 40 card oracle. The card stock is really nice. It's thick enough and it's shiny, so it shuffles pretty well. I find that gloss cards tend to be more pleasurable to shuffle. This is a longer, thinner deck, so it's about, you know, it's longer in my hand, but it's small enough to shuffle with ease, I would say. So if you've got smaller hands, this will maybe feel a little bit more approachable on shuffling. And then let's just ask for a message using the Forest Fae. Let's just say a little prayer. Forest Fae, guiding spirits of nature, of mountains, of wild places, of the land and seas, thank you for guiding us and for blessing this oracle deck with your light. And thank you for revealing to us what we need to know today. The first card we pick will be a strength that we have, and the second card we pick will be a challenge that we need to work on, something that is yet to come. And so it is. Okay. Don't they look nice? I'm into it. I was saying to Bob off camera, this is coming into my bedroom for sure. This is one of my favorite ones I've found yet. I think it's because it's so far away from what I create. And so there's something really magical about it for me. Okay, our strength is the Numina. Seek inspiration in twilight wanderings. Okay, so our strength is those downloads, that information and that inspiration that comes to us at bedtime. I don't know about you, but I'm a bedtime journaler. I go to bed with a number of different books in my journal, and I write down how my day went, and I often write down, you know, inspirations that come to me at night. I cannot keep my eyes open past midnight, I will be really honest, but I do find myself sitting up in my bed around 11 p.m. every night, and that's often when the greatest inspiration comes to me. So our strength is the Numina. Seek inspiration in twilight wandering. So when you're awake after dark, that is guidance that's coming to you from the Fae. And our challenge card today is this, what is yet to come. Forest Sister. The moon shines brightest after the storm. So let me just say this. If at the time of you watching this video, it feels like there's a storm happening in your life, maybe things are feeling disrupted, you know, all over the place. Maybe it feels, you know, like there's gusts of unseen wind coming. Maybe it feels like, you know, the rain is pouring down heavily. This is a message to say to you that the moon shines bright. And what that means is when this storm passes, you will be in the shiniest phase of your life. You will move into a more bright time. And this is really just a message to say, hang on in there. Light is coming. And the light is coming because it exists within you. Think of a question right now. Something you need an answer on, and let me pick a card for you. Hedge Guardians, walk Widdershins and seek the land under the hill. So the answer to your question is not in the direction you are moving. Find a new way. Move in a different direction. So if you're moving towards something, move the opposite direction, and that is where the answer will come to you. This has been an introduction to the Forest Fae Oracle, published by Rockpool Publishing, created by Nadia Turner. An amazing little tool. And I think this is one that I would absolutely put in people's stockings at Christmas time. This is something I would gift to people that just want to get more connected to nature. People like my friend Tristan, who's a mountain guide. He is going to love this. So check it out if you are called to the Fae, if you want to get back to nature and her messages for you. If you enjoyed this video today and you want to see more content like this, I invite you to like this video and subscribe. You have no idea how much it supports me by subscribing to this video. Thank you for your support. See you soon.